रामायम अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः येन धौता गिरः पुंसां विमलैः शब्दवारिभिः तमश्चाज्ञानजं भिन्नं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् ॐ नमः पाणिनिकात्यायनपतञ्जलिभ्यः शब्दविद्यासम्प्रदायप्रवर्तकेभ्यो मुनिभ्यो महद्भ्यो गुरुभ्यः विल् गो टु दि नेक्स्ट् सूत्रं 59th the second pada of the first chapter. The sutra reads like this: asmado dvayoscha. Here in this sutra, from the former sutra, ekasmin bahuvachanam anyatarasyam, these words will be anuvarti, following. This sutra contains two words, asmadaha dvayoscha. Asmadaha is the sashti ekavachanam of the word asmad. Asmad, this is the word we have learnt in Sarvanama, Sarvadigana. Asmad relates to I in the singular number, we too in the dual number, and we. Aham ekavachanam, avam dvivachanam vayam. So this asmad shabdasya, asmad shabda sambandhi karyam etat. That is why here he has used sambandha samanye shashti. Regarding this asmad shabda forms, he says dvayoscha. In respect of one, ekasmin anuvritti from the former, asmad shabdasya sambandhi, in respect of one, that is in respect of aham, plural can be used optionally. So also in respect of two, that is avam dvivachanam, in respect of two also plural number can be used optionally. So we have to relate these words here. Asmadaha ekasmin dvayoscha bahuvachanam bhavati anyatarasyam. That is how we have to combine these words. Ekasmin bahuvachanam anyatarasyam. In the place of one, in the place of aham, bahuvachanam vayam. Optionally, that is aham can be used, vayam can be used. In respect of dvayoscha, that is in respect of two, that is in respect of, in the place of avam can be used. Optionally, vayam also can be used. We will take one example. Aham bravimi. I speak. Bru vyaktayam vachi. Bravimi means speak. I speak. In the place of aham, we can use vayam. Vayam brumaha. Because the verb should be correlated to the subject. So vayam is in plural number. So brumaha is, so bravimi is ekavachanam, brumaha. That means here in the place of aham we have used vayam. Aham bravimi means I speak. Vayam brumaha ichyasyapi I speak eva arthaha, kintu that can be used in plural number also. In English also, previously we used to say, now we don't hear this, royal we. Royal we means that is used by kings. He will never say, I have done this, I will do this. We, he will say, royal we.
But verb also changes,
so vayam brumah. Yes, verb also has to change. That is a basic rule. The verb has to change because the verb, the vachana of the verb relates to the subject. Aham is singular number. So, bravimi is singular number.
I speak, we speak.
There in English, speak only is the form for both. So, aham bravimi in this place, we can say, vayam brumaha. The meaning is the same thing. So also in dvivachanam, avam bruvaha. We both speak. We both are speaking. Vayam brumaha, it can be said. That means in the place of avam, we are using vayam optionally. There is a vartikam here. Savisheshanasya pratishedho vaktavyaha. In case asmad shabdaha is used along with an adjective, then this rule will not apply. That is, optionality of a plural number or singular number will not apply. Example is, अहम् आचार्यः ब्रवीमि. आचार्य इज माय नेम. इट इज माय प्रोफेशन्स नेम आल्सो, बट माय नेम नेम आल्सो आचार्य. और लेट अस टेक ए कॉमन एग्जांपल गिवन बाय शास्त्र. अहम् देवदत्तः ब्रवीमि. हिज नेम इज देवदत्तः. अहम् देवदत्तः ब्रवीमि. आई देवदत्त आई एम स्पीकिंग. Here we are not supposed to say vayam devadattaha brumaha. It is quite unnatural. So aham, this word is followed by a visheshanam. How devadatta will become visheshanam? That is nominative visheshanam. Nominative visheshanam. Visheshanam can be by number. Two books, we say. Two is a visheshanam there. Raghuvamsha pustaka pustakam, we say. Raghuvamsha is a visheshanam. So here, devadattaha is a name of the person speaking, but it is the visheshanam, adjective of aham. So here, optionality of plural number is not there. We have to speak only in
singular
number. So also, aham yajnadattaha bravimi. Aham patuhu bravimi. His name is patu. Here the use of vayam is barred. Another vartikam is there. That is also quite useful. Yushmadi gurau ekesham. This rule pertains to asmad. In case of yushmad also, yushmad means thou, you two and you. Nowadays nobody is using this thou. This is the singular number of Yushmat Shabda in old English. Bible it is used thou. But in local language.
Thyself also.
Thyself.
Thyself also.
Thine Uchadaya. So Yushmat Shabda Shavishaye, this optionality of the plural number can be used only in case we are speaking about our guru. The guru is a respectable man. So we have to use the compulsorily we should not use, we need not use plural number, but we can use plural number to denote respect for him. It happens in all the languages. So when a guru is addressed by this word Yushmad, it can be optionally used in a plural number also. Example is, Tvam me guruhu. You are my guru. Thou Thou art my guru. In English, you have to say it. Art.
Yes.
Now we have nobody is using this thou and art. Thou art my guru. Suppose student wants to speak very respectfully, he can say, Yuyam me guravaha. Yuyam is in plural number, so guravaha, plural number. And this opinion, he says, Ekesham. Ekesham means in respect of some person's thinking. Some persons think like this. Ekesham matau. Kechana evam chintayanti. Atra eka means some people. Generally, eka is not used in eka is nitya eka vachanam. But here, some people, in that sense, we can use eka as a bahuvachanam also. Now we will go to the next rule. Phalguni proshthapadanamcha nakshatre. Here dvayoho bahuvachanam anyatarasyam. It will be following from the former sutra. Phalguni proshthapadanam. Phalguni is the name of a star mansion. Phalguni, star mansion, means constellations are there. This is a case, this is an astronomical word. There are some 27 mansions of stars mentioned in our calendar, in our astronomy. Phalguni consists of two, Purva Phalguni and Uttara Phalguni. So we say Phalguniyau. Phalguni is Ikaranta Strilinga Shabda. Phalguniyau means Purva Phalguni and Uttara Phalguni. Evameva Proshtapada. Proshtapada. This is Pullinga. Proshtapada means Purva Bhadrapada, Uttara Bhadrapada. We say Purva Bhadra, Uttara Bhadra. We can say Purva Bhadrapada, Uttara Bhadra. This also contains two stars. This is Phalguni, this is 25th mansion, lunar mansion. And this Purva Proshtapada is 27th, 25th and 26th. 27th is Revati. Ete Phalguni Proshtapadanam chaiti etau nakshatra visheshayoho namani. These are the names of particular nakshatra mansions. Here he says, dvayoho bahuvachanam anyatarasyam. Phalguni contains two stars, so it is naturally it is dvivachanam. But bahuvachanam can be optionally used. So also proshthapada. Purva Bhadra, Purva Proshtapada, Uttara Proshtapada. So that is also naturally in a dual number. That also can be used Bahuvachanam Anyatarasyam, Vikalpena. So the examples are, one person is asking a pandit, Kada Purve Phalgunyau. Phalgunyau, it is Vivachanam. This is one usage. Purve. Purva is the Akaranta Svilinga Shabda. Purve Dvivachanam. Because Phalgunyau is, it is in Dvivachanam. Purve Phalgunyau. Kada Purve Phalgunyau. One person is asking a pandit. Or optionally he can say, Kada Purvaha Phalgunyaha. Phalgunyaha is the plural number of Phalguni. Evameva Kada Purve Proshtapade. Here Proshtapada is used in feminine gender. Divachanam. Kada Purve Proshtapade. Otherwise, optionally, Kada Purvaha Proshtapadaha. here in plural. Purve prosthapade in dual number. This can be used only when Palguni prosthapada shabdas, they are used to indicate the name of a star mansion, but not otherwise. How otherwise they can be used? A particular person born in that nakshatra kala. Nakshatra kala will be there, a certain period of time in which that nakshatram rules. That is called nakshatra kala. A person born in that nakshatra kala, there also we can use palguni. That is, a pratyaya will be dropped there. So, when you use this palguni and prosthapada to denote a period of time wherein a person is born, the period of nakshatra kala, then because he said nakshatre, so only when they denote nakshatrams, they can be used optionally in Dvivachanam or Bahuvachanam. Otherwise, what will happen?
Singular.
Dvivachanam. Because they are naturally in Dvivachanam. That he, what will say? Palgunyau Manavike. Manavika means a lady scholar. A lady religious student. Manavakaha. Pullinge Manavika iti strilinge. Palgunyau Manavike. That means these two lady scholars, these two lady religious students were born in the Phalguni Nakshatra Kala. Because this is denoting Nakshatra Kala and not Nakshatra itself, this optionality is not there. They have to be used in dual number only. We'll go to the next rule, 61st rule. Chandasi punarvasvoho ekavachanam. Chandasi means in Veda, in Vedic language. Ashtadhyayi deals with Vedic language rules as also loka, laukika bhasha. Chandasi visaye, in Vedic language, punarvasvoho ekavachanam anyatarasyam. Punarvasu nakshatram, that is also seventh lunar mansion. It also contains two nakshatras. It is a combination of two nakshatras. So, punarvasu being a combination of two nakshatras, generally it should be used in dual number. But ekavachanam also can be used optionally. Udaharanam vakyam punarvasuhu nakshatram aditir devata. This nakshatra, the presiding deity is Aditi. Punarvasuhu ekavachane prayogaha. Otherwise dvivachane. Punarvasu nakshatram aditir devata. Punarvasuhu is in singular number. Punarvasu is dual number. So he is told ekavachanam anyatarasyam. Divachana, in the place of divachanam, optionally you can use ekavachanam also. Here also, it is in the case of nakshatra only. Suppose a person is born in that nakshatra kala, when we refer to that, we have to use divachanam only. Anyatarasyam ekavachanam nasti. Example is, Punarvasu Manavakau. These two male students, male scholars, they are born in Punarvasu Nakshatra. Because Punarvasu is a Dvivachanam, it is a combination of two nakshatras, so we say Punarvasu Dvivachanam Manavakau. So for Dvivachanam, Ekavachanam Anyatarasyam is an option, is not there here. Because it doesn't refer Nakshatra Vishayaha, it refers to a nakshatra kala visayaha. Chandasi chuktam kila. So this rule is not implemented in local, laukika language. So in laukika language, the naturality punarvasu is dvivachanam because it is the combination of punachatras, punarvasu iti prayoga in lokabhasaya. We'll go to the next sutra. Vishakhayoscha. This is also a star mansion, 16th in number. We have got 27 mansions, 27 nakshatras. So the 16th lunar mansion is called Vishakha. This is also generally used in Dvivachanam. Here in Chandas, that is Veda Bhasha, this can be used optionally in Ekavachanam also. So Chandasi Ekavachanam Anyatarasyam, that will be following in this sutra. Vishakha Nakshatram Indragni Devata. That particular deity, she presides over this Vishakha Nakshatram. Vishakha Nakshatram is in Ekavachanam. Optionally, we have used in Ekavachanam. Vishakha is naturally it's in Dvivachanam. So, Vishakhe Nakshatram Indragni Devata. These are the Vedic mantras. Now, we will go to the next sutra. Tishya Punarvasvoho Nakshatra Dvandve Bahuvachanasya Dvivachanam Nityam. This is purely local language, Laukika Bhasha. Chandasi is Nivruttam. Tishya Punarvasvoho Nakshatra Dvandve. Tishya Nakshatram Punarvasu Nakshatram. Tishyam iti ekam nakshatram. We call it Pushya also. Punarvasu Nakshatram, it contains two stars. Tishya contains one star, Punarvasu contains two stars. So total, when you combine these two, Tishya and Punarvasu, and make a samasa, it contains three things, three objects, three stars. Tishya is one, Punarvasu is two. So naturally, Bahuvachanam should be used. But here he says, Nityam Dvivachanam, there is no option here. Anyatarasyam is not there. We have to use it in Dvivachanam only, even though it contains three. One sentence we will take. Uditau Tishya Punarvasu Drushyete. As per the previous rule, Bahuvachanam is praptam. But here, Dvivachanam Nityam Vidhiyate. That means, Tishya Punarvasu Dvivachanam. Even though Tishya is one, Punarvasu is two, instead of Bahuvachanam, we have to use only Dvivachanam. Tishya Punarvasu Drushyete. Drushyete also in Dvivachanam. Uditau Tishya Punarvasu Drushyete. The Tishya Nakshatra and Punarvasu, two Nakshatras, they are rising. Uditau, they have risen. They are being seen by us. Here, Tishya Punarvasvoho Ichyuktam. So, this rule will not be applicable in the case of other Nakshatras. For example, Vishakha Anurathaha. There we have to use Bahuvachanam only. Optionally, compulsorily Dvivachanam Ichyuktam Kila, that will not applicable here. Vishakha Anurathaha, Athava Anurathaha. Vishakha Anurathaha. In Bahuvachanam only. Vishakha is generally used in Dvivachanam. Anuratha Yogena Bahuvachanameva Bhavet. Kintu Atra Bahuvachanameva Bhavati Dvivachanam Nityamiti Nasti. Here also, this prayoga only in the case of nakshatra visayaha. in the case of nakshatra kala visayaha, that is a person born in that nakshatra period, this is not applicable. Tishyaha manavakaha, we say. This boy, a scholar, a religious student, he is born in Tishya nakshatra kalaha. Tishyascha manavakaha. Punarvasu manavakau. These two boys, these two religious scholars, they are born in Punarvasu nakshatra kala. So he Punarvasu, because it is naturally in Dvivachanam, Dvivachanam is there. Punarvasu manavakau. We will go to the next sutra. This 60, 61 and 62, these three sutras, and 63 also, these four sutras, they pertain to star mansions, astronomy. Now we will go to the general sutras. 1 to 64. Sarupanam ekasesha eka vibhaktau. This is the starting sutra up to the end of the pada, 73. From 64 to 73, this particular 64 to 73 means 10 sutras. These 10 sutras are called Ekasesha Prakaranam, Ekasesha Vrittihi. Ekasesha means only one remains. Two or more than two, they are dropped. Regarding Ekasesha Vritti, the following sutras will be used. The sutra says, Sarupanam Ekasesha Eka Vibhaktau. Let us divide them. Sarupanam, in respect of words having the same shape. Sarupam means Samanam Rupam Yasya. Samanam Rupam Yesham. They are Sarupas. Having the same shape. Same shape means the letters. Letters contained in them. They are the same letters. Sarupanam Shabdanam Visaye. When you form a samasa, dvandva samasa, with Sarupa Shabdas, Eka Vibhaktau. Eka Vibhakti means in the same Vibhakti. In the Eka means same. Eka vibhaktau, in the same vibhakti, that is dvivachana vibhakti, any other vibhakti, sarupanam sabdanam eka vibhaktau prayoge eka eva shishyate. Anye kim bhavanti? Nivartante. They are dropped. Sarupanam Shabdanam Eka Vibhaktau Parataha Ekaha Seshaha Eka Rupam Shishyate Anye Nivartante. That means when more than one word in the same shape are used in one samasa, in one vibhakti, same vibhakti, only one word out of those several words will be persisting and the others will be dropped. Let us take a shabda, a vriksha. Let us say we have to indicate two vrikshas, two trees, and then apply dvivachanam, prathama vibhakti dvivachanam. Prathama vibhakti dvivachanam is av, the pratyaya is av. So on vriksha we have to apply this av. There are two vrikshas. So vriksha, vrikshascha, vrikshascha. Two vrikshas are there. Vrikshascha, vrikshascha. On this we have to apply dvivachanam. Av. This is dvivachanam vibhakti. Say that vibhakti. Vrikshaha, vrikshaha, samana rupam. Samana rupam. So only one word will subsist. The other will return back. Vrikshaha. Only vriksha shabdaha. Only one word will subsist instead of two words. So vruchascha vruchascha plus au iti sthite, vruchya eva shishyate, Ruchha plus au, Ruddhi, Ruchhau. Ruchhau means two trees. In Bahuvachanam also, Ruchhascha, 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 so on and so forth, any number. Plus Jas, Jas is the Bahuvachana Pratyaya. So here, Ruchha, Ruchha, several words are used in the same shape. So one word only will persist, will subsist. So Ruchha plus Jas. Pratamayoh Purvasavarnaha, Purvasavarna Dirghaha, Ruchhas, Ruchhaha. So in Ruchha, 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 whatever be the number of Ruchhas, only one Shabda will remain. Then here he says, Sarupanam. It is very instructive. If you take the counter examples, they are very instructive. Why he has told Sarupanam? If the words are not in Sarupa, the words may mean the same thing. The meaning may be the same, but for a particular meaning, you may have two or three words. So, if two words in different shape are used in a particular meaning, they are not sarupas. So, eka sesha eka vibhaktav, it will not be applied. Let us take an example. Plaksha is one word. Negrodha is another word. They mean the same thing. In English, it is said fig tree. In our local languages, we say banyan tree. So, Plaksha and Nyagrodha, even though they mean the same thing, same tree, they are in different shape. Different letters are there. So, when you combine them in one Dvandva Samasa, Plaksha, Plakshascha, Nyagrodhascha, if you say Dvivachanam or Bahuvachanam, then we have to say Plaksha Nyagrodhaha. Because they are not in Sarupa, even though they mean the same thing, all the things you have to be, both the things you have to take in. You have to take Plaksha Nyagrodhaha. Because they are not in the same shape. Eka Sesha does not apply here. And then Rupa, the word Rupa is taken. Sarupa. Samanam Rupam. Why this Rupa is taken? That means they should be in the same shape. The letters, the words should be the same shape. They may be having different meanings. This is quite opposite of the earlier example. There, Plaksha and Nyagrodha, they are having the same meaning but different shapes. Here, different meanings, but same shape. In that case, what will happen? There also, Eka Sesha will remain. Because Sarupanam, he said, example is, we'll take Achcha Shabda. Achcha means dice, a pachika used in dice. Dyuta Kreda. It has got another meaning. Achcha means the axis. Axis in astronomy and geography. So, Achcha has got two meanings. So, Achchascha, Achchascha. Achchascha. Suppose we apply Bahuvachanam. Because they are in the same shape, only one Achcha will remain. The other things, Nivartante. Achchaha.
But the meaning is different?
Maybe. Doesn't matter.
Referring to the
context. Achchaha means, it may mean axis, it may mean dice. Because they are in the same shape. So also, Pada Shabdaha. Pada. This Shabda has got two meanings. Pada means foot. In a sloka, 1/4 vakya, vakyam is called pada. Sloka pada. Pada is the same shape, but different meanings. Here also, Pada plus Pada plus Pada, in Bahuvachanam, it will be Padaha only. So also, Masa Shabdaha. Referring to the context only, we have to... Suppose if you are referring to Sloka Padas, then you Sloka Padaha. Suppose you are referring to the Padas of individuals, Padaha. Masa Shabdaha is there. Masa is a word used for what do you call in black gram. Black gram. It's a pulse. It has got another meaning. It's the name of a measure. Measure by weight. In olden days, this kilo, kilogram, grams, they were not there. This is decimal system. In olden days, some other words were used. Depending upon the kingdom, they were used. Some people, some kings have introduced some words to call weights by measures by weight or measures or length also. So, Masa has got two meanings. Because the shape is the same thing for both, Masaha. Referring to the context only, we have to understand. Now, here, we have taken Eka Seshaha, we have taken. Why at all we should say Eka Seshaha? Seshaha iti uchyatam. Suppose the sutra is rewritten like this. Sarupanam Seshaha Eka Vibhaktav. What does it mean? No, this is this Prachyudaharanam counter example we are quoting to demonstrate that not a single word can be removed from the Panini Sutra. If a single word is removed, entirely meaning changes. Suppose this Eka Sesha word, Eka is removed. What will happen? Sarupanam Seshaha Eka Vibhaktav. Sarupanam Seshaha, there are several words, Sarupa words. Seshaha, they remain. If you remove Eka, only one will remain, will not be there. All the Sarupa Shabdas will remain. If you use only two Sarupa Shabdas, both of them remain. If you use many words, many of them will remain. So that distorts the meaning. So this Eka Shabda is quite essential there, that cannot be removed. Also, why this? You just say Ekaha, Sarupanam Ekaha, Eka Vibhaktav, you could have said. Why did you say Sesha? Because our ancient rishis, we have constructed sutras, we have taught sutras, Alpacharam Asandigdham, Astobham Anavadjancha. That's what we have told in the preliminary classes. So, not even a single word can be removed. And the later grammarians, they question very incisively whether this matra could not have been uttered in Hraswa. Why Dirgha is uttered here? Even a matra kala difference also, they examined very incisively and supported Panini Sutras. So here, why we are using Sesha Grahanam? You could have said Sarupanam Ekaha Eka Vibhaktav. Then it may mean, but means we can misunderstand, it may be misunderstood like this. Sarupanam Ekaha. That means Sarupanam is in Shasti Vibhakti. Shasti Sthane Yoga is one paribhasa sutram. When in sutra a Shasti Vibhakti Yukta Shabda is used, in that place, that is the meaning to be taken. Shasti Sthane Yoga. Iko Yanachi. Ikaha is Shasti. Ikasthane, we have interpreted like that. Ikasthane yan bhavati. That means ik will be dropped and in the place yan will be adesha. So here also this adesha paribhasa sutram is there. Sarupanam iti shasti yukta shabdaha. And sarupanam sthane eka iti adesho bhavati. That can be, this meaning can also be derived by mistake. So to avoid that mistake, he has told Sesha, Eka Sesha. And then eka vibhaktau ichyuktam. Why at all this word is necessary? That means if sarupa shabdas are taken in two different vibhaktis, then eka sesha will not appear. Unless we take an example that cannot be understood properly.
Not in the same vibhakti.
Yes, not in the same vibhakti. Eka vibhakti means we have interpreted same vibhakti.
Yes.
In if you sarupa shabda, for two different meanings, when used in different vibhaktis, eka sesha will not apply. Very good example is given. Payaha, payaha jarayati. Here, payas shabdaha. Payas shabda is used here. Payaha, payaha. They appear in the same vibhakti, but it's not in same vibhakti. Payaha is prathama vibhakti. Paya, this second payaha is in dvitiya vibhakti. Because this sarvana napunsaka linga shabdas, prathama vibhakti, dvitiya vibhakti, same forms will come. Because swamur napunsaka ati sutrena, tatra su am, they are dropped here. So payaha, payasi, payamsi in prathama vibhakti. Again, payaha, payasi, payamsi, in dvitiya vibhakti also. So here, payaha, payaha jarayati. That means first payaha is used in prathama vibhakti. And here, incidentally, meaning also is different. Payaha means water or milk. So let us take this payaha, first word, as water. Second word, payaha, dvitiya vibhakti. Milk, let us take. So, what is the meaning of this word, sentence? Payaha, payaha, jarayati means it spoils. Water spoils the milk. If you mix water, the milk content is lessened. So, it spoils milk. So, the first word in prathama vibhakti, the second word in dvitiya vibhakti. Even though payas shabdaha, same shape is there, sarupam is there, but still we have to use both the words. We cannot apply eka seshatvam here. We'll go to the next sutra. Or he has taken another example also. Let us take that example also. Brahmanabhyam kritam brahmanabhyam dehi. You know this dvivachana pratyayam bhyam in your table of words. Would have observed. Bhyam comes three times. Tritiya, Chaturthi and Panchami. So here, Brahmanabhyam Kritam, Brahmanabhyam Dehi. In this sentence, first Brahmanabhyam is Tritiya. Second Brahmanabhyam, Chaturthi. What does it mean? A thing done by Brahmanas, two Brahmanas, a thing performed by two Brahmanas, a thing constructed by two Brahmanas, let it be given for two Brahmanas. Second Brahmanabhyam is in Chaturthi. Dana Kriya is there, so we have to use Chaturthi. Vipraya Dehi. Gam Dadati, Vipraya Gam Dadati. The person who is receiving the charity, he is placed in Chaturthi Vibhakti. So, Brahmanabhyam Kritam, Brahmanabhyam Dehi. First Brahmanabhyam, it is in Tritiya. It is in Tritiya. Second Brahmanabhyam in Chaturthi. Because they are employed in two different Vibhaktis, this Brahmana, Brahmana Shabda, one will not persist, but both of them will be there. Then, we will go to the next sutra. Vruddho Yuna Tallachanaschedeva Visesaha. This is also Eka Sesha Vritti Sutram. Here, Sesaha Eka Vibhaktav. They will follow here. Vruddho Yuna Tallachanaschedeva Visesaha. Here, we have to divide the words. Vruddhaha. Yuna. Vruddha is Prathama Vibhakti. Yuna is in Tritiya Vibhakti. तल्लक्षण चेत एव विशेषः। हियर वृद्ध शब्द एंड यूना शब्द, यूना मीन्स युवन इत्यस्य तृतीय यूना, यंग यंग इति अर्थः। बट हियर एक्चुअली वृद्ध शब्द एंड युवन शब्द दे आर नॉट इंडिकेटिंग वयोदश, ओल्ड मैन एंड यंग मैन, दट मीनिंग इज नॉट देयर हियर। यस ग्रामेटिकल टेक्निकल मीनिंग इज देयर इन ए वंश, इन ए लीनियज, इन ए क्लैन, इन ए क्लैन नेम्ड आफ्टर ए ग्रेट पर्सन, सपोज वशिष्ठ, वशिष्ठ क्लैन इज देयर, ए फेमस क्लैन, देयर वृद्धापत्य प्रत्ययास आर देयर, युवा प्रत्यय प्रत्ययास आर देयर अकॉर्डिंग टू ए साइंटिफिक ग्रामेटिकल रूल। That means the what is the rule for Ruddhapatya? A rule says it will be, we will be coming across afterwards. Apatyam pautra pravruti gotram. Gotrapatya pratyayasya sutram etat. Gotrapatya, Ruddhapatya nasti. Sorry, I have mispronounced it. Gotrapatya pratyayaha. What is gotrapatyam? अपत्यम पौत्र प्रभुति, वन वंशकर्ता इज देयर, फॉर एग्जांपल वशिष्ठ, तस्य पौत्र प्रभुति इट इज गोत्रम कॉल्ड, इट इज कॉल्ड गोत्रम, बट इज गोत्रम इज ए टेक्निकल वर्ड हियर, गोत्रम डजंट सिंपली मीन वंश, हियर गोत्रापत्य, गोत्रापत्य प्रत्ययास आर यूज्ड टू डिनोट the vamshakartas pautra prabhuti right from grandson and downwards for indicating them with the name of vasishtha on vasishtha shabda gotrapatya gotra pratyayas have to be used
yani pratyaya gargari thyo yani
yes we will be coming across so many things in apachya prakaranam tatita prakaranam will be coming across later it will be appearing in fourth and fifth adhyayas so also yuvapatya pratyayas are there what is this yuvapatya that means jivati vamsyetu yuva is the sutram that means in this pautra prabhuti clan the descendants of that vamshakarta when the vamshakarta is alive the descendants will be denoted by a particular pratyaya that is called yuva yuvapatya pratyaya purvam gotrapatya pratyaya here yuvapatya gotrapatya and yuvapatya what is the difference when the vamshakarta is alive when the vamshakarta is alive the pautra prabhuti right from grandson onwards they are enjoined yuvapatya pratyayas generally gotra apatya prabhuti gotra apatya pratyayas so yuvapatya pratyaya is a special case of gotra apatya pratyaya here this rule says when two words are combined in a dvandva samasa first word vruddhapatya vruddhapatya gotrapatya pratyayah and then yuna along with yuvapatya pratyaya word gotrapatya pratyaya word first word and then yuvapatya pratyaya second word when that first word is used along with second word yuna means tritiya along with yuvapatya pratyaya yukta shabdah then eka sheshah bhavati eka is not here vruddhah shishyate vruddhah shishyate yuva nivartate the word relating to vruddhapatya pratyaya, that only will stand, persist. The other word, yuvapatya pratyaya word, that will disappear, that will be dropped. Provided there is one conditionality here. Tallakshanascheva visheshaha. Between those two different words, that means the shape will simply, little be changing. Shape will be changing. When a gotra pratyaya and yuva pratyaya are used, there will be little change in the shape of the words. Let there be change, no doubt. But tallakshanascheva visheshaha, between those two words, what is the distinction between those two words? Vishesha means the difference. The difference in those two words should be tallakshanascheva. That means vruddhapatya and yuvapatya. This word starting from the same vamsakarta nama, a particular pratyaya is used for vruddhapatyam, apatyam, pavutra, bhapati, gotrapatyam, and then a different pratyaya is used to denote yuvapatyam. So, when the difference of the words, it is accounted only because of this vruddhapatya, gotrapatya and yuvapatya, when that difference is only because of them and not due to anything else, the difference is not due to anything else, then say vruddhah shishyate yuva nivartate. That is the meaning of this. We will take one example. Garga. Garga is the Vamsakarta's name. Gargaha. When you use Gotrapatya Pratyaya on this, it will be called Gargyaha. A pratyaya is added, it imposes vruddhi, adi vruddhi. So garga will become gargya. Garga plus ya, ga will be elongated, gargya. Gargya is vruddha gotrapatya pratyaya yukta shabdaha. And then yuvapatya pratyaya shabdaha, gargyayanaha. So this Gargya Shabda and Gargyayana Shabda, they are conjoined in a Dvandva Samasa. Gargyascha, Gargyayanascha. What does he say? Only Gotrapatya Pratyaya will only remain, the other Pratyayanta Shabda will return, will be dropped. So Gargya, Gargyayana, Gargyascha, Gargyayanascha, Gargyayana will be disappearing, Gargya plus Av, Dvivachana Pratyaya Av, Gargyav. So Gargyav means Gargyascha, Gargyayanascha. Here, the difference between Gargya and Gargyayana, the difference is only because of the Pratyaya and not because of anything else. They are the same clan, same Vamsakarta. Another example is Vatsyascha, Vatsyayanascha. Vatsyaha iti Gotrapatya Pratyayanta Shabdaha, Vatsyayana Yuvapatya Pratyayanta Shabdaha. Vatsyascha, Vatsyayanascha will be Vatsyau. Here, unless you study the Pratyudaharanam's counter examples very closely, you will not be able to understand the sutra perfectly. Now we will take one Pratyudaharanam. Why he is told Vruddhaha? Suppose Vamsakarta's name is taken. Instead of Gotrapatya Pratyaya, let us take Vamsakarta's name, and Yuvapatya Pratyaya also we will take. Gargascha, Gargyayanascha. Just to observe the difference, Gargaha is Vamsakarta's name. Gargyaha is Gotrapatya Antashabdaha. Gargyayana Yuvapatya प्रत्ययांत शब्द सो गर्गश्च गार्ग्यायणश्च दिस इज वृद्ध संज्ञा इज नॉट देयर हियर गोत्रापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्द इज नॉट देयर एर्लियर गार्ग्यश्च गार्ग्य गार्ग्य इज गोत्रापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्द हियर वंशकर्ता'स नेम इज टेकन देयर इज नो प्रत्यय एट ऑल गोत्रापत्य प्रत्यय इज नॉट यूज्ड देयर सो बोथ ऑफ देम विल रिमेन गर्गश्च गार्ग्यायणश्च गर्ग गार्ग्यायणौ द्विवचनम् एंड द सेकंड वर्ड यूना सपोज युवापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्द इज नॉट देयर देयर आल्सो दिस रूल विल नॉट अप्लाई गार्ग्यश्च गर्गश्च गार्ग्य इज गोत्रापत्य प्रत्यय Garga is Vamshakarta's name. Vamsha Mula Purusha's name. So here, because this Yuva Pratyaya Anta Shabdaha is not there, so Gargyascha Gargascha Gargya Gargau. And third counter example is Talachanaha Ichuktam. That means the difference between two words should be the difference arising out of Gotrapachya and Yuvapachya and not the difference arising out of anything else. Let us take one example. Gargyaha Gargavamsiyaha Vatsyayanaha Vatsavamsiyaha Gargya is Gotrapachya Pratyayanta Shabdaha वात्सायनः इति युवापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्दः हियर बिकॉज देर इज ए सेकंड डिफरेंस हियर गोत्रापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्दः इज देयर युवापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्दः इज देयर बट डिफरेंट क्लैंस वन इज गर्ग द अदर इज वत्स बिकॉज सम अदर स्पेशल डिफरेंस इज देयर दिस वृद्ध विल नॉट बी शेष एकशेषः दट मीन्स What will be the Gargya Vatsyayanau? So, by understanding this counter examples, the meaning of the main sutra will be firmly implanted in the brain. Another counter example also is there. Eva Ichukta Mata. तल्लक्षणश्चेदेव विशेषः वै दिस् एव शब्दः इज यूज्ड हियर द डिस्टिंक्शन बिट्वीन द वर्ड शुड बी दट अलोन एंड नथिंग एल्स फॉर एग्जांपल भागवित्ति भागवित्तिकौ भागवित्ति भगवित् भगवित् इति एकः वंशकर्ता तस्मात् भागवित्ति इति बुद्धापत्य प्रत्यय गोत्रापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्द भागवित्तिकः युवा प्रत्ययांत शब्द वेन यू कंबाइन दिस टू सेंटेंस दिस टू वर्ड्स बिकॉज फर्स्ट भागवित्ति इज गोत्रापत्य प्रत्ययांत सेकंड आल्सो युवापत्य प्रत्ययांत शब्द बट हियर बोथ ऑफ देम विल पर्सिस्ट बिकॉज भागवित्तिक शब्द इट कंटेन्स ए लिटिल a difference arising out of something else. Not only this Bhagavit Bhagavit Vruddhapachya and Yuvapachya. Even though both words contain Bhagavit, Bhagavittikaha ichukte Yauvi Sauvira Deshasya Bhagavittikaha. He was born in other Desha, not in the same Desha when Bhagavit where Bhagavit is born. So another point of difference is there in those two words. Sometimes it is in kutsa to accuse him to ninda vachaka shabda. Sometimes in ninda vachaka shabda also kan pratyaya is used. Bhagavittikai means a person who has to be detested. A person who deserves garhata. So that garhata visayaha is a difference. Additional difference. That is why this Eva शब्दः इस् एव शब्दः इस् टेकन् हियर्. सो भागवित्ति भागवित्तिकौ भागवित्तिकशब्दः भागवित्तिशब्दः ईवन् दो दे अरैज़् औट् आफ् भगवत् शब्दः एण्ड् वृद्धापच्य एण्ड् गोत्रापच्य एण्ड् युवापच्य बट् स्टिल् देर् इस् अनदर् डिफरेन्स् डिफरेन्स् इन् देर् इट् इस् भागवित्तिक इट् इस् ही वास् बोर्न् इन् डिफरेण्ट् कण्ट्री एण्ड् आल्सो ही नीड्स् ही डिसर्व्स् अर्हत ईस् निन्दनीयः. दट् इस् वै बिकास् अनदर् पायिण्ट् आफ् डिफरेन्स् इस् देर् हियर् एकशेषत्वं नास्ति भागवित्ति भागवित्तिकौ भवन्ति. नौ वित् दिस् फ्यू सूत्रास् विल् कम् टु अवर् रिफ्रेन् इस् शान्तिमन्त्र. ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः.